breast ultrasound has evolved dramatically over the last 5 to 6 years. We have the luxury of having two new breast ultrasound units at DeKalb Medical Center. These units also have a new component called elastography. Sounds very fancy. Basically, it just tests the tissue stiffness. The stiffness of the breast tissue can tell us what's underlying that area. Could it be cancer? Could it be a benign process? Ultrasound traditionally has been used not for screening, as we do with mammography, but for problem solving. If you or your doctor feels a mass or perhaps a localized area of discomfort, or perhaps your mammogram has found a small area we need to assess in more detail. The elastography will let us determine the stiffness of that tissue and sometimes may indicate perhaps we need to do a biopsy or perhaps have you be sent to a breast surgeon for additional assessment. Also, it can help us potentially avoid a biopsy in areas that we feel like are most likely benign on the ultrasound morphologic or the shape and size of the lesion and the ultrasound characteristics also with the stiffness of the tissue. Breast MR has really changed the evaluation of breast cancer. This has been around for a number of years, especially in Europe. We here at DeKalb Medical Center have been using breast MR for the last 4 to 5 years and actually have recently started using a computer-assisted diagnosis program to help interpret the breast MRs. We found that breast MR is an essential adjunct to staging breast cancer. Patients with known breast cancer, we can evaluate other areas of involvement in that same breast, which may affect breast surgery, whether you have breast conservation therapy or perhaps more aggressive therapy. Also, it can help us stage the local nodes in the axilla, also to assess the internal mammary region nodes, which was a very difficult area to traditionally assess. Also, it helps us evaluate the opposite breast in patients with known breast cancer, which we know can have cancer in 4 to 5% of the cases. Also, I'm very excited about the future of breast MR because screening is going to be so important, especially in patients with a high risk of breast cancer. This will be extremely important. Patients with genetic markers, the BRCA 1 and 2 marker, which you may have heard about in the media. This is very important because mammography doesn't have the sensitivity to detect as many cancers as the breast MR does, especially in these high-risk groups. Also, we know that now extremely dense breast tissue is an independent risk factor for breast cancer. Patients, especially with a high family risk, should consider having breast MR on a yearly basis to detect cancer. Also, we can use breast MR to target areas for biopsy, which we cannot see on mammography or ultrasound. In summary, I think that breast MR is going to be extremely useful for screening high-risk patients, is also very useful in problem-solving cases where breast ultrasound and traditional mammography don't detect abnormalities. Also, you should know that breast MR has the highest negative predictive value for breast cancer. In other words, if you have the test and it's negative, the chance that you don't have cancer is 9 to 95%, certainly higher than traditional mammography and digital mammography as well as ultrasound and a combination of both.